story. I have to share that with Pocket someday. Hi, Pocket.
Hi, Pocket. I'm home.
Well, I can't stay very long
because I have to get right back because I just asked Bobby and Billy and Jeff. You know, we're going to go back to school and clean erasers.
Oh, that's
fine. There you go.
How'd you get that job, Pocket?
Well, that's for when you're a pet.
You're a teacher's pet?
I'll bet.
I told you you'd like school, Pocket.
Well,
I
like it.
Fun things to
do. I like it. I like it 2 inches.
Oh, that's pretty good, Pocket. So who's going to help you?
Billy and Bobby and Jeff. And I need one more guy that's big and strong. And I can't think of somebody. Will you help me think, Paxton?
Oh, okay. Let's see now.
Put my books down.
Who's in your class?
I don't know, but I have to think about it. I need another big, strong boy.
Steve Chafee.
Who?
Steve Chafee. You know Steve. That he's a nice little guy. He likes to do work like that around. What's the matter?
Well, let's think about somebody else.
Well, what's the matter with Steve? He's one of your friends.
Well,
I mean, remember he helped you on the paper route? You know, remember that? He helped you out a little bit there when you wanted to go away.
I think better with my shoes untied in my head.
Pockets, what's wrong with Steve? Have you had a fight with Steve?
Steve who?
Oh, Pockets, you're really getting me mad. Now, you know who I'm talking about. Your friend Steve.
Steve who?
Steve Chafee.
Let's think about somebody else. Johnny.
How about Steve Chafee?
You sound like a broken record. How about Steve Chafee? And I want to tell you what's wrong with Steve Chafee. He's too little.
Too little?
That's all I want to hear about it. Shh. Case closed. Boom.
Since when do they have to be a certain size to help clean erasers, Pockets?
Because if you're little and you're down there and you go like this and clean the erasers, all the chalk goes up in my face.
Oh,
that's
I've heard
what. And not only that, you have to be big to be able to go on those erasers. Just ask any kid that's ever done it. You got to be big and strong. And you can't be little.
Size isn't that important,
Think about get off the record. Think about somebody else. George and Dan. Hey, maybe Dan Woods could help us. Dan's a big kid. How about Dan?
Well.
Or how about his brother, Jack Woods? Jack Woods is a big kid.
I know. Would you like to hear a story, Pockets?
I'm so glad you didn't say, how about you know who.
Hey, what about if I read you stories and then maybe we'll think of somebody to help you, okay?
Steve Chafee.
It's up to you, Pockets. I just like to share a story with you that I was reading before you came in.
Sit okay, down. Sit down on the floor.
Okay.
Why do I have to listen to a story? That's so dumb.
Well, it's just a short one, Pockets. I think you'll like it.
Okay.
Once, when a lion was asleep, a little mouse began running up and down upon him. This soon wakened the lion, who placed his huge paw upon the little mouse and opened his big jaws to swallow him. "Pardon me, O King," cried the little mouse. "Let me go this time, and I shall never forget it. Who knows but that I might be able to do you a good turn one of these days."
Oh, he's too little. Look at that little mouse and that great big lion.
The lion was so tickled at the idea of the mouse being able to help him that he lifted up his paw and let him go. Sometimes later, the lion was caught in a trap. The hunters who desired to carry him alive to the king tied him to a tree. And while they went in search of a wagon to carry him on, just then the little mouse happened to pass by and, seeing the sad plight in which the lion was, went up to him and soon gnawed away the ropes that bound the king of beasts. "Was I not right?" said the little mouse. "Little friends may prove great friends." Just thought I'd share that with you, Pockets, while you're thinking.
Just think, that little tiny mouse helped that
great big lion.
Mm-hmm. Little friends make great friends sometimes, Pockets.
Do you hold my teddy for me?
Hello. This is Pockets. Could you get me Steve's house? Steve Chafee, that big boy that lives down the street.
Yes. Thank you. Steve, this is Pockets.
Hi.
Hey, you want to clean erasers with us now after school? It's right now, because I have to go, because Billy and Bobby and Jeff are waiting for us.
You would?
No, you're not too little. I'll sit down while we clean the erasers, and then it won't go in my face, okay? Okay, see you next patches.
Okay.
Here, take the phone. I have to go to school. Bye.
Goodbye, Pockets. Remember that, boys and girls, little friends make great...